I don't know how you are, but I'm not kidding. I have an IT department that lives in my attic now. I cannot turn the lights on in my house anymore. It's so smart. It's doing so many things. It's doing it by itself, right? And so, yeah, we have all started to experience this stuff, right? Got the thermostat there. This thermostat's doing some stuff. I'm setting it sometimes. Sometimes it's thinking for itself. But you know what it's doing fundamentally? Do you know what that technology is doing? It's learning about you. That intelligence that's inside your home knows whether you're a user or a seller of energy at any given moment, right? So the simple example that I can use is you got your car, your Tesla in this case, plugged in your garage, and it knows your usage patterns of your car. And it's watching Bruce's price of the commodity at that moment, and it knows that that car is not going to be moved most likely for the next 6 hours, so it's a seller, right? Because you're tying together that knowledge against a market transparency, and you're deciding for yourself what your best choices are for you as a customer. I'm going to say it again, because just in case I didn't make the point earlier, that started with the smart meter. That was the entry into intelligent use of energy and figuring out, oh, I don't just get a bill every 60 days from Toronto Hydro. I wonder when I use this much energy. Now you truly have this capacity to interact with the grid. That's the genesis of the notion that we will be having our homes and businesses run by intelligence that knows what we want, and it'll be taking advantage of the grid and the opportunities associated with it.